So here we are up at the elephant house. Behind me we've got Anne, and she's our elephant we've got here at Longleat. She came to us originally from the circus, and she came to us here to retire and live out her golden years.
We think that Anne is probably the oldest elephant in Europe. She is a quite a unique elephant, and what she gives back to people when you work with her and understand her is phenomenal.
From the time of Anne's arrival here 11 years ago, certain aspects of her health have improved. For example, her trunk condition, she can now reach up to the hay nets and hold her trunk up. Normally elephants, of course, they would be herd animals. You'd normally see them together. We're always reviewing with independent experts, our veterinary team and the keeping team, what is best for Anne. And based upon her ongoing health conditions, her arthritis, the recommendations is that she wouldn't be capable of moving physically. She wouldn't be able to stand up if she was knocked over. It would not be fair at this time in her life to try and mix another elephant in with Anne, given the fact she's a very old lady.
We've noticed that her health is slightly declining. Nothing to alarm us, but it's we monitor it.
My name's Tony Nevin, I'm an osteopath. As an osteopath, that means I'll be looking at her muscles, joints, and her ability to move as freely and normally as possible. When Anne arrived, she was already suffering from arthritis. Osteopathy is really good at helping reduce the effects of that. This type of work allows her to move more freely and be more comfortable. Feeling here, I can move the skin over the muscles, which is a sign of good health and good circulation. If I move up here, it's tighter, and I can lift up and start to actually manually release some of that tension. She's only in this small area whilst we're doing the treatment or for foot care and other stuff like that. It just allows more safely work around them. And so already we're beginning to get some slack in these muscles. We can't turn the clock back, but what we can do is we can slow the clock right down. And she usually likes to lean quite hard back against me. She's got a sense of humour. And I liken her to a sort of a cheeky granny where she's got the sense of humour, but she looks like butter wouldn't melt. So you have to be prepared for her to play little, just gentle little tricks on you.
So we have an exciting opportunity to form a bit of a link between the work that Tony does and translating it into helping elephants out in Asia as well.
By working with Longleat on this, what we're hoping to do is actually bring osteopathy into parts of Southeast Asia and actually work in situ with elephant people there to train them up with some of the techniques that we've been using with Anne. And then eventually they will train others and we can get it to mushroom out. Some of the countries I'd like to go to take this project would be Thailand, Nepal, Cambodia, Laos, Vietnam, Sri Lanka, India, basically anywhere where you've got Asian elephants. We're in a very unique position to be able to do something that could have massive ramifications for elephant welfare.
Me personally, and for us here at Longleat, formulating this link to support Tony going out there and helping those elephants at the same time as Anne, with Anne being a fantastic ambassador for her species.
So we're getting towards Anne's tea time. In the bucket, we've got these fodder beets. So what we're going to do is bury them in the big sand mound. When Anne comes out, she can dig in the sand and eat them at her leisure. She started to perform this natural digging behaviour again, which is really, really nice to see. Anne is super intelligent. She's one of the most intelligent elephants that I've worked with.